Okay, guys, Michael and Tish. Michael Segura, Letitia Montoya, we're on our way to Chicago. Are you excited, Mike?
Yes.
Okay, let's walk out the door. Go
on,
Mike.
Hold on, that light should be on.
Okay,
why are these lights on in here?
We're walking out the door. Okie dokie. So, here we go. Let's let Michael come out. He's a national delegate. Drum roll. Blah, 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 blah. Boom! We're going to the airport. Okay, so we're on our travels to Chicago. We'll see you once we're in the car. Okay, everybody, we're leaving the driveway, so we're on our way to Chicago. Okay, so we're leaving, and I'll talk to you in a few. Hey guys, we're on our way to Chicago to the conventions at the airport. Okay, so we are in the plane and on our way to Chicago with the delegation of New Mexico, and we also have Teresa Hunter, who is on the plane with us as well. So
Mayor Keller.
Mayor Keller. So there's a big group of us on the plane right now. Yeah, so we'll see you guys when we land. So remember, Letitia and Michael Segura. So we're almost here, huh, Michael?
I'm more tired right now.
Than anything?
So we only got an hour's sleep last night.
Is that it?
Well, we went to bed at 2:30, we got up at 4, and we had an hour and a half.
Yep, because we worked till then, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we're almost there. Mike and Tish. Okay, everybody, we are in Chicago, as you can see. So, I will show you everything that is going to happen now all today, and then I will post it tonight. Okay, guys, Mike and Letitia. Okay, guys, we are at the hotel in Chicago. Check this out. We are... Yes, yes, yes. Okay, we are going to... Yes, yes. Okay, come on, guys, let's go into the hotel. Okay, guys, we are gonna go check in. Let's check out the hotel. So this is the inside of the hotel, and it's over here. They have the DNC 2024, and then we will go across and get Michael's credentials, and then walking to an event that the governor of our state is having for the delegates, where they go to the convention.
I'm gonna get my credentials.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. How are you?
Hey, how you doing, Letitia?
Thank you to all of our elected officials that joined us. Bienvenidos y
Gracias por estar aquí con nosotros. It is my great honor to introduce to you a leader whose dedication and vision shine brightly in our community and beyond. Congresswoman Teresa Ledger Fernandez. As a steadfast advocate for the people of New Mexico, Congresswoman Ledger Fernandez embodies the spirit of the commitment and progress that the land of enchantment needs. Teresa's tireless efforts to safeguard the interests of New Mexican families is truly inspiring. From championing critical issues like affordable healthcare and education, to protecting our beautiful environment, to pushing for robust economic development, and fighting for wildfire victims. Congress Teresa Ledger Fernandez shows up, and she is a beacon of hope and determination. Her leadership is not just about addressing today's challenges, but about building a future where every New Mexican has the opportunity to thrive. Today, as we gather to support the remarkable work of Democrats up and down the ballot, we are also energized by Congresswoman Ledger Fernandez's unwavering support for our broader goals. Her advocacy in Congress ensures that our values and aspirations are represented at the highest levels of government. In a time when leadership matters more than ever, Congresswoman Teresa Ledger Fernandez stands as a true champion for progress and a brighter future for New Mexico. And at this time, it is my great honor, my great privilege, to introduce to you a dear friend and colleague, our Congresswoman Teresa Ledger Fernandez.
Our about to pay rent in the contract to a particular millionaire who actually evicts him. Right? No, 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 but that's how the Democrats are. That's how the Democrats are. Democrats know that we need to make sure that we have housing, that we make housing affordable, and that we have home ownership. That we have home ownership. Did you know that New Mexico has one of the smallest gaps of home ownership? That we have the largest home ownership rate for Latinos? Isn't that a good thing? And we do it in New Mexico. And what happens? I love Kamala Harris's idea of down payment assistance.
Yes.
We know, right? We know that. Yes. And I have, we have in New Mexico. We have in New Mexico. I call it a project at HomeWise, where we are doing exactly that. We are connecting people with a down payment assistance so they can have a home of their own and they can believe in a future for them. And I have my home of you on that. I have my home of you on that group and show them that we do it in New Mexico, and then we're going to do it nationwide so that when you're from Santa Fe, Chicago, Pittsburgh, wherever it is, that you get to stay and have a home where you grew up and the place you love. Because that's what we need, is a home of your own. So can we
have
a home of your own?
Yeah.
We just love our diversity because we know that diversity is not adversity.
Right.
Diversity is unity.
Unity.
Right? Diversity is unity. Because we come from a place where they teach Dewa, Tiwa, Kara, Toa, Kara, Apache, Zuni, and Spanish. It is spoken in our kitchens, and it is spoken in our classrooms. And we reject. We reject trust, division, and hatred, and revenge. Because we know that there is not an office. There are sort of anything. No, sir.
Thanks.
And Kamala Harris and Tim Walz and the Democrats know that we are bound together with one idea, one future, and one
just ain't true. You know what I said to her? I
I said, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And so that's why I wanted to introduce to you our mayor of Albuquerque, Tim Keller, because he and I share that little bit of heavy metal background. So we look kind of normal, but don't believe it for a minute. So please put your hands together for Albuquerque's current mayor, Mayor Tim Keller.
Oh my goodness, that was definitely the first time I've ever walked on and people stomping. You can't tear this off. So, which is a good segue. You know, we are grateful to have an awesome party chair. Let's give a round of applause. I know we all like to have a good time, but we also know when to get serious. And so, I think the good news is, we are going to win.
Yes.
I feel really good about that. And part of that, by the way, is because of the 19th. So if you don't know, grab a button, ask someone. I got educated today. How, what anniversary is it?
The anniversary of the application of the 19th Amendment, going back to 1920, which gave women the right to vote.
Yeah. All right, so I just want to share a few things with you first. To all our delegates, how many of you are a first-time delegate? All right, first-time, is that right with you? First convention, pretty exciting. So I got my extra bling, my buttons, because I am excited. And I will tell you, once upon a time, I volunteered at a convention, and my job was to hold the welcome sign. So, welcome to the convention is awesome. And I remember thinking that, you know, I'd actually like to go to the convention someday, not just hold the sign. So it's full circle for me about 20 years later. But I also know that I know what the other alternative looks like. And our congresswoman articulated all of the policies and all of the challenges with what another term for Trump would be. And how many of you have Washington DC in that building? You know, as mayor of Albuquerque, I remember, I had 3 years under him, and it was terrible. He was deporting immigrants. He was actually coming to our city and closing it down, for which many of you remember he still owes us $400,000.
Yeah.
And we sent him a bill, and he gets called by clutch agencies. That's a true story, by the way. But he is a disaster for cities. I would just tell you, unmitigated disaster for cities. He also tried to destroy the control of our police department, whether you like it or not. Love it, be ours, not the feds. And so I do not want to have that ever again in our country or for Albuquerque or New Mexico.
Amen.
That's right. But I also want to appreciate this moment that I think begins really tonight. And it's a moment for standing up against all of that, but it's a moment that affects us right. We understand as a country it does, but I just want to highlight one issue to connect the dots. You know, tonight in Albuquerque City Council, there is a fight to raise the tipped minimum wage. How about helping our servers? Wait, to raise. I'm getting to you, folks. Raise. There is a fight to either raise or decrease. This is also what our vice president is fighting for. But I want you to know, on the same day that we're here, we are fighting this fight at City Council in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And I do want to highlight, you know, one of our delegates is actually, she's not going to be there tonight. Because she's going to be actually sponsoring the bill. So let's give a round of applause for our City Council, Nicole Rutgers. So while we're all having a good time, she's going to be working, and she's going to be walking the walk, and I'm going to be on my cell phone watching her the whole time. But I will tell you, this is what it's about. This is what Dems do. Up and down the ticket, we walk the walk. Whether it's tonight at City Council, or it's all the way for the next 4 years. Because, I want you just to take a look around here for a minute. I know we've been talking to people we know, kind of glance around, look at everyone here. And I want you to soak in who's here with us tonight. Because I will tell you, something that we all know, but sometimes we forget to say. This group of people, and the 4,000 people that we're going to join, right? Knock on wood, hopefully, but I believe it's going to be true.
we are going to elect the first woman president in the history of the United States. And it is going to be one of those moments. I'm telling you, when that happens, all of us for the rest of our lives are going to say, do you remember when I was there to nominate Kamala Harris as our next president? Thank you so much for that. Thank you for and of course, for being here today and for being here in our party. Thanks so much.
Real quick, because we have some incredible people in this audience, if you are a county party chair, looking at you, Kate Turnbull, Marisol, I'm looking at you, Marisol Enriquez, if you are a county party chair, please come on down, Chair Hoskey. I'm looking right at you. That's all I'm trying to say. Please come on down here. Woo! Let me tell you about this. I think this will be my county party chairs. I think this is it for our delegation, right? Is Madam DNC Committee Woman Trish Ruiz here yet? She's also a county party chair. My friends, I want to take a moment just to acknowledge how hard our counties work to make all of this happen. Because there's only a handful of us at the state party level, and the folks who really mobilize our voters, the folks who build the networks of support we need to elect Democrats up and down the ballot, start doing the work right now with veterans. Okay, so can you all join me, please, in giving a huge round of applause? Thank you all so much. Would you please give me a favor to see you in the morning and introduce yourself to me? Yeah, I'm going to ask you good evening, everyone. My name is Brenda Hoskin, County Chair from McKinley County. Thank you. come on down here.
Good evening.
Good evening.
How y'all doing? Are you guys excited?
Yeah!
You guys excited to make history this fall? Elect the first woman president of this country?
Hell
yeah! Yeah! Again, my name is Dwayne Duffy, vice president for the next world Patrick Fry. You know, this year is amazing. You know, we're celebrating the 19th Amendment. But for me, as a tribal citizen, it's also very important. 100 years ago, Congress finally passed a bill that granted us citizenship, known as the SIRA, the American Indian Citizenship Act. And so we are proud of that. You know, we're here in New Mexico and across the country. Us as Native people, we were granted the right to vote in all elections in 1947, and we are here exercising that. We are here playing our part to ensure that we are elected officials up and down the ballot to represent and protect our sovereignty, to protect those and honor those treaties that we signed with the United States, and to protect us as American citizens, no matter what you look like, who you love, what religion you believe in. That is why, you know, we're here supporting our Democratic nominee, you know, Kamala Harris, and her vice president, Walz. They're going to go forward, they're going to champion these values, these things that we hold dear to us, and we're going to win. And we're going to continue to see progress in the next 4 years. And I'm proud to be here, I'm proud to be part of this moment, and I'm proud to carry this message home to galvanize our own tribal members to get in the vote, get in the polls and vote, and make your voice heard.
My picture?
Yeah.
Let us always remember when we fight.
We win!